Oh, God!
Yo, I'm not some fucking lab rat here for your amusement. So now what? There we go. What the hell? Oh, what the hell? Jesus, there's cameras everywhere.
I want to know what it means to be a killer. You ever been to the art museum downtown? They got this painting by a guy, I forget his name, famous painter. He did portraits of slaughtered cows hanging on hooks. You take a normal person to a slaughterhouse, and they will puke their guts out. You make it into a painting, and suddenly it's art. There's no difference between the two. Not really. Don't look at me like that. You know I'm right. You get it. I know you get it. You got to do something that matters. Make people feel something they've never felt before. Shatter the illusion that any of us are really in control. Think of the most profound thing you've ever done. The most beautiful thing you've ever created. And I promise you, it's nothing compared to watching the life bleed out of someone. To see the fear in their eyes. To feel them pawing at you for release. To hear them pleading, begging. That moment when someone realizes they are at their end. That's when you feel it. That's true art. That's what you have to be. An artist. A sculptor. An architect. I see the gleam in your eye, Agent Monday. You're not fooling me. Look! Ah, look at you now, huh? Am I gonna be your first? Well, come on then, huh? I'm right here. This room is soundproof. You don't even have to wait for a plane to fly overhead. Good, huh? But the blade makes for such a prettier picture. You've got potential, Agent Monday. If you truly want to be an artist.
Me to try?
Stay close to me. Who says self-help books don't work?
Charlie threw it down here earlier.
Of course he did.
Thank you.
Jamie. It's coming from through here.
Thank you. Please! I'll do anything!
Help me!
It's a fake.
I can't see a light.
A fucking fake.
Please. They never hurt anyone. Just leave them alone. We'll do whatever you want. No! Please! Just leave them alone.
Shit! It's me!
Jamie?
Thank God. What the hell is this?
The mirror was two-way. It's totally a little pervert creeper room. Demet is watching us and sneaking around between the walls.
Have you seen Mark?
No. I've seen Demet, though. He's creeping around.
Jesus, what is all of this?
He's got video feeds, recording decks, a mixer big enough for countless mics.
He's watching everything.
It's more than that. He's got utilities running through here, hydraulics, electrics, everything.
It's like a nerve center for the whole building.
It's a director's suite.
Maybe we can use it to find a way out. Look for something to unlock the outer doors.
This all connects. This is how he's getting around the house.
This is a lot. This is top-end gear. I mean, I know he's rich, but you could launch a rocket from in here.
Charlie would say this guy is a fractured psyche, that he's wearing a mask to put what he's doing on a different personality.
That's probably just his theory, because he can't reconcile a human doing this stuff. He's been tracking us since we arrived. Mark was last seen in the basement.
What do you think it is?
I think it's a mistake to say he's just crazy. He is in full control of what he's doing. He's just not wired like the rest of us.
What's the difference?
Crazy implies out of control. Take a look at this. What is that?
The guy we saw murdered.
Was it set up?
There was no groundskeeper.
Why would he do that?
To scare us. To get us in the mood for his fun and games.
Nice.
Wait, he's wearing the mask as part of the performance. At best, maybe he's insecure about something and it gives him confidence.
Insecure? Like, low self-esteem? Is he uncomfortable at parties? Did his mommy not hug him enough?
Bad parenting can definitely be a factor, but it could be a shitty dad just as much, or an uncle, any adult figure, really. What is this?
Hi, Mr. Monday. This is Lucinda Price from Twilight Prairie Care Home. I've tried to call you a couple of times. I understand that you're making voice recordings of your mother, and we do believe in supporting relatives, and of course, you want to...
Over here!
Look at this. It's all his little tricks of moving walls and crap.
Nothing in this shitbox is real. He controls everything from here. It's a murder factory.
You're right. We should use this against him.
I want to find Mark, not play Demet's game.
If we trap him, we can look for Mark without looking over our shoulders the whole time.
Jamie's right.
Okay, look. He's in here, right? So we get him to go down this hall, and we trap him between these two moving walls. There's no other way out of there. He'd be stuck.
So how do we get him to go down that hall?
One of us is going to have
to be bait.
No, no way.
It's too risky, Jamie.
So is letting him run free. I'd say that's more dangerous. Come on.
No. No, no way. If something goes wrong, one of us will be dead.
Yeah, I'm not super into doing it. But I am done being scared of what's around every corner.
There's no second chances here.
Who's gonna do it?
It's my plan. I'll be the bait.
You're joking.
No. One of us has to.
If you're sure, just... If it looks like it's going south, get the hell out of there.
No argument here.
You could use that as a weapon if need be.
I'm gonna hang on to it. I'm more likely to need it. Okay. That's enough of a moment. Let's do this.
Stick to the plan.
Obviously.
So how do we get out?
Third floor must be a work in progress. Okay, be ready. You're gonna have to time it right to trap him and not me.
Jamie, don't do anything stupid. If you see him, please just run. You have to come back, okay?
Copy that. All right. Here goes nothing.